Hey, welcome to Lisa's Spirit Readings. This is a general reading for the sign of Capricorn for mid to late February. It's getting towards the end, so I'm going to say mid to late. Kind of a little bit late for the mid-February, leaning towards late February. This is going to be a general reading, so it probably won't fit for all of you. If it doesn't, just leave what doesn't fit. Leave all of it if none of it fits. And if you run across this video a later date, I feel that it's a message you were meant to see. So I'd like to tell everybody that. Hoping all you Capricorns have been doing well as we move towards spring, which is a good thing. Good thing for me. I'm in a colder climate. Okay, so like I said, this will be a general reading. I'll be looking into your recent past energies, current and near future. Okay, I've got one card here. Spirit, can I please have two more cards? Spirit, please give me two more cards. Sign of Capricorn, thank you. One more card. Oh, thank you. So in the recent past, you have the Ten of Pentacles, which is it's about stability, maybe family life, children, home life. Looks like that's been going well for you recently. Your current energy, you have the Star, which is kind of the hope card, the wish card, the dreamer card. And then you have the Page of Swords, which can mean a new communication, new spark, an idea. Let me go ahead and clarify your recent past. Could you please clarify? Ten of Pentacles, please. Please clarify. Ten of Pentacles. Oh, no, don't want that. It's too many. Okay, that one I want. Five of Wands. Wands are about creative flows, creative energy. It's a five, and that usually can signify some kind of conflict. The Five of Wands to me is about working with others. So you may have been working on things with family members, friends, maybe neighbors. Bottom of the deck, you have Six of Swords, but it was in reverse. This is usually about moving away from something. It could be an uptick of communication of some sort, but this to me always signifies moving away from something, moving away from maybe thoughts that didn't serve your greater purpose. Let's see what else I can get on this Five of Wands. Spirit, please clarify the Five of Wands. Can you please clarify the Five of Wands? The Sun, so the Sun's, it's one of the best cards in the deck. It's about, to me it's a feeling of freedom. You can see she's, or maybe not, it's really, there you go. She's kind of in a field, you know, the sun's on her face. And it's a carefree feeling of being free. So your recent past here seems like it's been pretty good, with the exception of maybe some conflict with other people, minor conflict, because you do have the Sun here right after the Five of Wands, which tells me that, you know, whatever that is, seems like it's been worked out. Let me try and clarify your current energy, which is the Star card. So maybe you're hoping for something right now. you're kind of connected to, you know, maybe your dreams, future ideas, future thoughts. Spirit, could you please clarify the Star card? Spirit, please clarify the Star card. Oh, okay. Too many. Do not want that. Spirit, please clarify the Star card. So right here. So now you've got the Justice. So you might have something, situation, and you're wondering if you're going to see any justice out of it. Some balance, perhaps, with the situation. You might feel like things are going one-sided, where you don't want them to be. Let's see if I can get more. Oh, okay. So you've got the Ten of Swords, which is the ending of a difficult cycle. Well, not necessarily difficult, but a lot of times it is. The ending of a cycle or a situation. Maybe this is because it's clarifying the Justice. It could just be that there's some kind of situation going on now, and you're wanting justice. You're wanting a resolution for it. And then you have the Two of Wands. The Two of Wands is about looking towards the future. Wands are a creative energy. They represent the fire sign. And this could also represent maybe needing to get out a little more. Wanting to do something, but feeling a tad bit stuck, or maybe, you know, torn on which way to go. And in your near future, you have the Page of Swords, which I said could be a new communication coming in, maybe an email, a phone call, the message of some type, or it could signify some new thoughts that you have swirling around in your head about maybe a new project or something. Okay, and then to clarify the Page of Swords, we have the Queen of Swords, which is really about having the clarity of thought. So, you're clear thinking about what you want moving forward. You don't have any doubts about what you're doing. You know, you're moving in that direction of going forward instead of backwards. Let me see if I can get another card. Oh, thank you. So then we've got the Nine of Swords. And this is clarifying the Queen. So it could signify, you know, the Queen, she's got her thoughts together. This can be an overload of thoughts. It can be anxious thoughts, some confusion, something maybe on your mind keeping you up at night. It's kind of a struggle in your thinking. There might be one thing that you're not seeing as clearly as you are with the other things, because you've got the Queen of Swords and the Nine is clarifying the Queen of Swords. So she's looking towards this energy, which is kind of that confusion, anxious state of mind. So you might want to be a little bit, careful, watchful of maybe some overwhelming thoughts you might have. Let me see if I can get more clarification. Spirit, could you please clarify the Nine of Swords? Please clarify the Nine of Swords. Oh! Not that. Okay. please clarify. Thank you. Yes, so we've got the moon and the five of pentacles. And the moon's about emotional work. You've got the moon here, and there's a wolf on each side of the moon, and she's under the water. So this can be about maybe some more negative type thinking that might kind of sneak in. And you've got this after the nine of swords. You just might have something, maybe some thoughts buried down that you might have to deal with. And then the five of pentacles. This is, the fives are always about a little bit of a struggle. You have another, yeah, you have a five, you have the five of wands also in your recent past. But this is kind of, an exhaustive looking energy here. You can see it better from back here. So the pentacles are up here on the door, and the door is locked, but there is a key right here behind her. So it's kind of like you might not be noticing what's right in front of you when it comes to whatever these thoughts are with this moon energy that you need to deal with. It's kind of a struggle of really clarifying thoughts that you might have that aren't the best thoughts to have. You know, can be confusion, doubt, anything like that. Let me see if I can get some advice here for these. Spirit, could you please give me advice for Capricorn? Advice, please, for Capricorn. Eight of Pentacles, so that's, you know, about really working towards your goal. Sometimes it can mean that you're working too much towards your goal and not being as relaxed as you should be. It always symbolizes, like a workaholic, putting out a lot of energy for something. And then you have the Eight of Wands, which is really that creative fire energy all going in the same direction towards something, and it's a faster moving energy. That's clarifying the Eight of Pentacles. So it's like you're really moving fast towards this. Could I please get a card to clarify the Eight of Wands? Thank you. The Devil. So, the Devil can signify some temptation, maybe dealing with your own demons, whatever those may be, and it could just relate to watching your thinking, so you don't get overwhelmed, making sure you're not going to work too hard at whatever this is you've got coming towards you in your recent future. Just looking over your cards, I've got them so covered up that I can't see them anymore. I'm trying to get a better look. My table's a little, well, actually I do have more room to slide them back. My table's not wide, so I usually kind of fan them down. So I think this is just in relation to the Eight of Pentacles you've got in your near future, which to me, like I said, is usually symbolizes working. It's working hard, but sometimes you can be working too hard and too much. And I think that's what this is trying to say is, you know, keep at it, but just don't let it overwhelm you. Don't let it consume you. Spirit, could you please clarify the devil? Thank you. Four of Pentacles. Sometimes we can hang on too much to something also. Maybe don't hang on so tightly to whatever this is that you're working, you're going to be working so hard at. Kind of let it flow a little bit more. Let me grab my other cards here. Let me go back to your recent past a little. Your recent past actually look good with the Ten of Pentacles and family life and the Sun card here. Spirit, could you please clarify the recent past? Oh, gosh. Tell you what, I've had some butterfingers today. Okay. So this one, these two came out, I'm going to keep them. So King of Wands and King of Pentacles. So you've got two kings here. The King of Pentacles is about that stable, balanced energy, which I think goes along with your Ten of Pentacles here, relating to maybe your family, stability, financial issues. King of Wands can be an assertive energy. These could represent two different people, one being more laid back, the King of Pentacles, you know, financial advice, stability, that type of thing. King of Wands can be aggressive at times. This is the fire energy. It could be a fire sign. But it kind of feels like in your recent past, you've got the stability, but maybe you're kind of yearning for something more, more fast moving. You might have some boredom perhaps with, kind of life lately, which with COVID and everything, you know, a lot of us have had boredom. It's getting better, but you know, for the past couple of years, it's been this type of energy, which actually you also have in your current cards here, of just kind of wanting to get out and wanting some more excitement, and that might be what this is. You know, you got the Star card here. Maybe you're just hoping for more excitement in your life. And you might not be sure how to do that. But it looks like you will be with this, you know, Eight of Pentacles. And maybe the Devil here in your near future. Or, I'm sorry, that's your advice from Spirit. It might be saying, like, you know, you can have that more thrilling type of life. Just be careful you're not too tempted with certain things. Kind of like, don't go overboard. Let me see what else I can get for your current. Spirit, could you please clarify the Two of Wands? Could you please clarify the Two of Wands? Please clarify the Two of Wands. Please clarify the Two of Wands. Spirit, please clarify the Two of Wands. Okay, thank you. So you've got the Wheel of Fortune. Fortune can be the ending, beginning of a cycle, and it's actually clarifying the Two of Wands here, which is a little bit of doubt, any doubting energy, kind of figuring out which way to go with something. And the Wheel of Fortune is kind of saying, you know, go ahead and make that change. You know, life is about change, so it's constantly changing and we're constantly evolving. Let's see what else I can get here. I guess Spirit wants me to do it that way. So Queen of Cups, clarifying the Wheel of Fortune. Yeah, so I feel it's, you know, making this change, whatever this is, would be really good for you emotionally. It could also mean that this is going to be emotionally difficult, but I don't think so, because the Queen of Cups is really about having your emotions in check. You know, the Queen of Cups, she's emotionally sensitive. You know, she's very caring about other people as far as their emotions. She's very empathic, you know, intuitive when it comes to emotions. So I don't think it's a struggle with emotions. I think it's showing a clarity of emotions with this. And even though you have the Justice, I don't feel like it's a legal matter. I feel it has more to do with just some balance, you know, maybe clarifying something in a relationship that needs to be worked out, that type of thing. It doesn't feel like anything major. Get some more on this advice here. Spirit, please clarify the Four of Pentacles. Spirit, please clarify the Four of Pentacles. Seven of Swords. So you might have to watch out in the future about some deception. Somebody might be wearing a mask, and that could be where this Devil card comes in here. Somebody might try and take what you've been building or what you're going to build in the near future here. So Spirit saying, like, just watch out for a wolf in sheep's clothing, or you know, somebody try to get away with something they shouldn't be getting away with. Let me try and get another card on this. Please clarify the Seven of Swords. Please clarify the Seven of Swords. This could also signify somebody playing games with communication style, because swords are often about communications, thoughts, but communications. My gosh, we've got way too many cards here. Got the Chariot, which is a movement, a balance. King of Cups. That's your third king. That's emotional energy. The Tower, which is about a kind of a shake-up in your life, a change, and I'm sorry, this is the Knight of Cups, but you have the King of Cups here. So the only king that you don't have, you've got the Pentacle, the Wand, the only one you don't have is the King of Swords. That's a lot of masculine energy. So it's more aggressive than the female energy. These could represent people, like in this case over here in your recent past, but I don't feel that they do. I feel it's more a message to kind of try to keep yourself balanced out evenly in the near future. And also on the bottom of the deck here, you had the Strength card. One of my favorite cards. I mean, I don't like this light reflecting. So this is, the two sides of you, the Lamb and the Lion. And knowing how to balance the two, bringing out that strength when you really need to, and knowing when you don't need it, and using that softer lamb-like energy. Let me pull some oracle cards here. Spirit, could you please give me an oracle card to clarify for me? So slippery. Oh. On the bottom of this deck, you have beauty. It's in reverse. Maybe you don't quite feel like yourself lately. Maybe you need some, maybe you need to remember, that you're worthy, that you do have beauty. The one that came out was Spirit Guardian of Spring. I've gotten this one a couple times. It's about activation. So I feel this has to do with the way that you're moving forward with this, the spark of whatever this is. I feel like, in the past you had the stability, the family life, because you've got the Ten of Pentacles was the first card in your recent past. But I feel like maybe you were just kind of feeling blah, kind of bored with life, wanting some excitement, maybe some travel. But there might be something getting in your way because you've got the Justice here. So it's like you're wanting some resolution for something right now. And it might be even... maybe there's somebody else involved and you're wanting to do some things differently and they don't want to. So you're kind of wanting to resolve that as you move forward. But with the Page of Swords the Queen of Swords, you know, you're moving in the right direction as far as your thoughts go. As long as you don't let them kind of consume you, where you have this Nine of Swords here, where that can kind of bring on anxious thoughts. But it really does look like this is moving in the right direction, as long as you don't overwork yourself. Don't put more in than you're getting out of it. Kind of take your time, and try not to hold on too tightly. You know, maybe don't try so hard. Okay, I'm gonna take this one because it's... Yeah, so Wizard of the Woods, and this one's about focus. So this is a reminder to keep your focus in the right direction and on the right thing as you move forward with this. It's much like this Eight of Pentacles, which is similar, but to me the Eight of Pentacles is always... It's good if it means you're working at it. And I guess reverse would be working too hard at it, but I think there can be a fine line there sometimes when we don't realize that we're overworking. It doesn't necessarily have to be anything about a job either, just you could, you know, be overworking too much in any area of your life. Okay, Spirit, could I please have another card? Thank you. I think I got two here. So Butterfly Spirit is transformation. And then you have Raven Spirit, which is truth. So you have activation, focus, transformation, and truth. And I think this is actually... I don't think the truth has anything to do with you. I think the truth has more to deal with whatever it is you want justice for, or you want that resolution of a problem or a situation that... and that's kind of been going on right now. That's in your current energy. And I think this is saying that the truth is going to come out, or you will have that resolution and even stick to your own truth as you kind of transform through this energy of kind of maybe being stuck or bored, wanting more excitement in your life. You know, it could be a new career. I think it's just a little... it might be a little disagreement in your family life, you know, maybe with your spouse or, you know, immediate family, whoever. I feel like you're really wanting to get out more, travel more, maybe go on some vacations. Maybe it has to do with a career and it's about traveling for a career change or that type of thing. But I really feel it's a good, you know, you're in a good place with this. So I think if you keep your eye on the prize, you will end up working this out and really moving in the direction that you want to go, that you want to go, you know, staying in your truth, staying in your good spot in your head as far as clear thinking. Don't let yourself get bogged down too much. Maybe stick to more of a plan so it doesn't become overwhelming. But I think it's a good thing. So I hope that this was helpful for some of you. And if it was, please go ahead and subscribe so you can get notified. My info is down below in the description box. And I hope you guys have a great week. Bye-bye.